My name is Oliver Bradshaw, and this is the first of many videos on box sash windows that are brought to you thanks to Mighton products. Now, to give a little bit of background as to why I've involved Mighton in this video series, I made 17 of these box sash windows for a project in 2013. When I was asked to make some more windows for that exact property as an extension, I contacted Mighton and asked them if they'd like to get involved with making a video and doing a bit more of an in-depth series on how to make a box sash and give a bit more awareness of how to install and what their products actually end up looking like in a finished job. And we're going to see every process, but in a kind of snapshot manner. So there's not going to be an awful lot of detail, but it's going to give you a good idea of the work involved in making a box sash window.
I've got some really fancy boxes. I've got four of them out here.
Thank you.
anymore. Ah, it's beautiful. Beautiful. the top sash at the top of the window, and the inside face is on the inside of the window. Sit it on them blocks. I'm going to turn the unit over now and work on putting the inside Georgian bars in place. We're trying to guarantee that these bars are on nice and straight and even from the edges of the sashes at the top and bottom. So again, take one of these bars, hold it nice and tight to that. I can check it with the one next to it and then seat that back in place.
Be a little bit looser because you've got that wiggle room of the pocket, so they tend to not. They just push in and then work from that bead. Lift the bead so it shortens it in length, and then pushing it back down straight will just pressurize it into place so you get a nice tight fit.
When we're using the hand tool, I think it's a lot safer option on a finished window. And that's it, your window now cannot go past this point here. Thing to remove is the pocket, so we've got access to the box screw. Again, we might have a little bit of paint stiction that should come out nice and easily. We drop him in there, then we pull. And then pull it through.
so the knot is completely concealed in the cavity of the weight. We can take the weight of we can pull on the cord to take the weight of the steel weight, move it past the wagtail, and just let it sit into the sash box. Now we're at the fun bit and we can put the first sash into place. It beads out here at the top, the entirety of the sash. Like so. Here's how the catches look when they've been installed. So they actually come right out. What that gives you is a nice bit of air gap at the top